everyone, this is Amir, and today I'm going to show you some tricks on using Excel, and these include using the Vlookup function and selective copy. But before I get into that, I would like to show you how to lock a function. If I write a simple function here, like this, in this cell, you all know that if I drag this cell from up to down, what happens is that Excel updates the cell for me, right? So this one is the cell right above it, plus one, and this one is the cell right above it, plus one. So Excel does that for you, but in case you want to basically avoid that, it's pretty simple. You have to use dollar sign. So if you use dollar sign before the letter portion of the cell address, this is the letter that does not get updated. And if you put this dollar sign right before the number, it's the number that does not get updated. So, like, if I change this function from R4 plus 1 to R$4 plus 1, and now drag it down, you can see neither one of those formulas are updated. All of them are R4 plus 1. And if you put dollar sign behind the letter does not get updated. So if I write another function here, And you know that if you drag it from left to right, the letter updates, right? This is R4, this is S4, and this is T4. So if you put a dollar sign right before the letter, and if you drag it now, the formula does not update. And if you put a dollar sign right behind both of them, like that, neither the letter nor the number, neither one gets updated. And as you can see, all of them are the same cell plus one. Pretty straightforward. The only thing that I want to add to this is that F4 is the letter to, is the key that basically generates the dollar sign for you. And if you hit a different, if you keep hitting it, you know, you can get different dollar sign behind either the letter, the number, or both of them. All right, with that, I would like to show you how you can use this to create a table. Sometimes you want to create tables in this format in such a way that this cell will depend on properties on this and that together. Like, so in this case, I want to basically make a table, and I want each cell to be the sum of the values on the top and on the left. So this, I want this cell to be this value plus that value. I want this cell to be this value plus that value, and so on. So simply, you know that your function has to look like that, right? Well, you all know that if you drag it left from left to right or up to bottom, as if you look at the function, it does not work correctly. As you can see, basically it's not correct. I want this to be this cell plus that cell, not this cell plus that cell. So the way to basically solve this issue is to lock the formula. But how do you have to lock it? Well, this, all values that you see in this column, what do they have in common? They all have the same letter. This is E5, this is E6, this is E7, and so on. So all of those cells have the same letter, right? So this is the letter that has to be locked, right? Remember that if you lock the number, it won't work. On the other hand, this F4, this value, which represents all cells that are in the same row, they all have the same number, right? This is F4, this is G4, this is H4, and so forth. So for this F4, the 4 has to get a dollar sign. And now if you drag it from left to right and up to bottom, as you can see, it works perfect. This is this plus that, and this is this plus that, and so on. Adding the values probably is not something that you would need to do, but as an example, this is how you have to lock the, when you address this cell and that cell, this is how you have to lock it so that when you drag it down, it works correctly. So remember, this value has to have the letters locked, and this cell has to have the number locked. And that way, when you drag it down, it works perfect. All right, you need to know that so that you could do some cool stuff with VLOOKUP function. But what is VLOOKUP function? Well, it's a pretty useful function. Let me show you what it looks like the lookup. All right. It takes four values and returns a result. The values that it takes, it takes a letter, a value, a character, or anything, and then it tries to find it in a table and return another value that shows up in front of that number in a column on the right-hand side of it. What do I mean by that? Let's say you have this table, and you want to look up the value that shows up two columns from this 10 here. So this table, I just made it up. Let's assume that these are some student IDs, and these are some information, data 1, data 2, data 3, and data 4, for these students. I just made them up in such a way that we could track the results. And by the way, the link to download this file is in the description of this video. So let's say I want to somehow extract the data 3 in front of 12. So this is what VLOOKUP can do for us. VLOOKUP takes this 12 as one of the values that you basically provide this function with, and then it'll try to find and extract a value that shows up in front of it. And how it works, it's pretty simple. So you do VLOOKUP, and so the first value, VLOOKUP value, is what you want to what you want the VLOOKUP function to look for. And in this case, it's 12. Let's say I'm looking for the value that is in the third column right in front of 12. So I want VLOOKUP to look for 12, and then you'll have to give it the address of the table. I want to find it in this table. Before I continue, there is one thing that I want to mention, and that is selecting the table. You'll have to be careful with this, because what happens is that this value that VLOOKUP is looking for has to show up in the first column of the table. So if you somehow fail to select the table correctly, VLOOKUP will not work. So be careful with that. The way that you'll have to basically select the table is that the value that VLOOKUP has to look for has to show up in the first column. All right, and then you'll have to tell it which column in that table you want the value of to be returned. So in this case, for example, I want the value in the third column in front of 12 to be returned. So I enter 3, and then this true or false is the accuracy of this lookup. So if you do false, it looks for exact match. It exactly looks for 12. But if you do true, like if you also put 12.1, probably it'll look up 12 for you. In most cases, you really wanted to look for exact match. So you do false and hit. So you're telling VLOOKUP to look for 12 in this table and return the value in the third column right after this 12, and you want it to exactly look for 12. So if I hint, so my I expect this function to return B12, and it is returning B12. So this is how it works. It's very useful, and you could do some cool stuff like selective copying that I'll explain later in this video. You could also actually get it to do more. So let's say you have a list of students. You want to look for student ID 5, 8, 10, and 15, and you want this VLOOKUP function to extract data 1, data, data 1, and data 3, and data 4. So let's say you want to VLOOKUP, you want to basically extract these values for these students. So if I could write a VLOOKUP function that will basically look for that and find it in this table and return the value that I put here in this cell, that would be great. That'll do what I am exactly after. So the data 1 is in the second column, data 3 is in the fourth column, and data 4 is in the fifth column. So I'll have to do VLOOKUP. I want this VLOOKUP to look for this in this table, right, and return the value in this column with respect to the first one. And I want it to look for exact match. So if you want to do stuff like that and you are wondering how to lock this formula, first go ahead and write the sample formula, right? And then try to figure out how you will have to lock it. So this value, if you remember the example that we did in sheet 3, this value needs to have its letter locked, if you remember. And this value, which shows up here, needs to have the number locked, right? So anytime that you want to make a table, this is the way to lock it. And you want this whole table to be locked. You don't want it. It's the same table for every single member of this table, right? So you want it to be locked in all directions. I used F4 to get Excel to generate the dollar signs for me. And that's it. So if you drag it from left to right and up to bottom, it works perfectly. So as you can see, this V looks up. It looks for this value and returns the value in this column. It looks for this and returns this. And as you can see, the table is not changing. So VLOOKUP could be very, very helpful, especially if you're working in a lab. In many cases, the results that you get from an instrument is in such a way that is difficult to work with. And if you know how to use basically get a VLOOKUP to sort the data for you, you're good. Okay, the next thing that I want to show to you is the application of VLOOKUP to do selective copy. So let's say this is another example of getting the data from an instrument or from a source that is not in the way that you want. So let's say you have some data that are showing up in this format. So assuming that these are the name of some students and these are grades for course 1, course 2, course 3, and course 4. Let's say you have your data shown up in this format, but your ideal case in the spreadsheet, as you all know, is something like that, right? You want your data to look like that, right? So this is the ideal case. So you basically, what you need to do is to basically copy these every 5 cells, right? You don't want to, so you want to copy this, 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 and so on. In this column, you want to copy this, this, this under, in this column under course 1, for example, whatever that is, and so on. So in order to do that, I've seen some other videos on YouTube that people do it differently, but to me, it's confusing. Using VLOOKUP, I think it's really, really simple. All you need to do is to put a number and on the left hand side of your source data and increase that number by 1. So you can simply write something like this, put 1 in front of the first data and then do this equals above cell plus 1, right? All you need to do is to right click there and Excel generates those data for you. The next step is to put numbers that are showing up on the left hand side of the values that you want to show up here. So assuming that this is the name, what do you want to show up here? You want this to show up here, right? So you want the data in front of 1, 6, and 11, and so on to show up here. So all you need to do is to put 1, 6, and 11, and in general, the above cell plus 5, the repeat. You know, you have 5 different data, a name and 4 grades for 4 courses. So our repeat is every 5, right? So we do each cell equals above cell, above cell plus 5. And all you need to do is basically get Excel to generate this, you know, certain number of them for you. I mean, probably you won't need that many. Okay. All right. I think you all know what to do by now. You simply have to VLOOKUP this value from this table, right? So you simply do VLOOKUP this value in these two tables, in this table, and return the value in the second column and look for exact, right? So it allows you to selectively copy data and probably I should say extract data from this sort, and it's perfect. So if you rewrite this function, so how do you rewrite this function for this one? If the grades for course 1 are showing up in front of 2, 7, and 12. So they are showing up in front of this value plus 1, right? So simply you do VLOOKUP this plus 1. And you want it to look into the same, in the same table, return the value in the second column, and look for exact match. If you double click, you can see A, C, D, those values are showing up perfect. So let's say you have 10 different grades, right? So you don't want to write this function 10 different times. So this is how you could basically use, you know, a combination of what I said so far. So you want, let's put 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Right? So if you could tell VLOOKUP not to look for this, but to look for this plus this and put it here, that will do the job for us, right? So instead of writing this equals VLOOKUP this, so you would say not this, but this plus that. So for this column, it'll be looking up 1, 6, 11. For this column, it'll be looking up 2, 7, and 12. And this is exactly what we want this function to do. But again, the way you are selecting that is in the format of a table, right? So you want F3 to have a dollar sign here and G2 to have a dollar sign right behind the numbers. Right? Oops. Oh, I forgot to lock the table. So, and of course you want the table to be locked because you don't want the table to change. The table is the same for every single member of the state of the VLOOKUP table. Okay, seems like we have selected more than enough. Alright. As you can see, you could extract data in any format that you want. VLOOKUP is extremely powerful for extracting data from a set of a set of data that are in weird format. So again, what this VLOOKUP here does, it adds this plus this, which is 8, right? And 8 is the value, and looks it up in this table. And 8 is the value for course 2, and it's exactly for course 2 and actually for Jackson. So it exactly shows up in front of the second column, which we will assign for course 2, and it's also showing up for Jackson, and it works perfect. And that's it. Alright, if you liked my video, I would appreciate it if you would like it and subscribe to my channel, and have fun. Thanks for watching.